Hi student, in last lecture we have started to solve exercise number 1.4 which is depending on the derivatives of parametric function, and in that lecture we see question number 1 and question number 2. Now we are going to solve our next question, that is question number 3. Find if x is equal to a under root sec theta minus tan theta, y is equal to under root a under root sec theta plus tan theta, then show that d1 upon dx is equal to minus y upon x. So first see, x is equal to a and y is equal to, we simplify this, x upon a is equal to root sec theta minus tan theta, and y upon a is equal to sec theta plus tan theta. So square root ke paas square root aapke liye kaadna hai, kya karoge, taking square on both sides, taking square on both sides, therefore x square upon a square is equal to sec theta minus tan theta. Say equation number 1, and here y square upon a square is equal to sec theta minus tan theta, equation number 2. Now first here we are going to add these two equations, adding equation 1 and 2. Adding equation 1 and equation 2. Then see here, x square upon a square plus y square upon a square is equal to sec theta minus tan theta plus sec theta, here it is plus theta. So sec theta minus tan plus sec theta plus tan. So minus tan and plus tan will it cancel here. Sec theta minus tan theta plus sec theta plus tan theta. Then minus tan plus tan we cancel. That is x square plus y square upon a square is equal to 2 times sec theta. Sec theta plus sec theta, that is 2 sec theta. Therefore see here, x square, so sec theta is equal to, ite kay milel aplyala, ite 2 multiply, so x square plus y square upon 2a square. Value of sec theta is x square plus y square upon 2a square. Same equation first here. Now we are going to subtract these two equations. So subtracting, equation 1 from equation 2. 1 from 2. This is 2. So y square upon a square minus x square upon a square. Subtracting equation 1 from this, so is equal to sec theta plus tan theta minus, subtraction karte to sign change hoti hai, to minus sec theta minus tan theta. Now see here, minus sec theta and minus minus plus tan theta, so here sec theta will get cancelled, and tan plus tan, that is 2 tan theta, x square y square minus x square upon a square. Therefore tan theta is equal to y square minus x square upon 2a square. So from first equation we will get the value of sec theta, and from second equation we will get the value of tan theta. Now we know that sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. All of you know this is an identity. Sec square theta minus tan square theta is 1. What is value of sec square? That is x square plus y square sec theta, that is 2a square whole bracket square, minus tan square theta is y square minus x square upon 2a square whole bracket square is equal to 1. Now see here, take square. First we expand this, x square raised to 2, that is x raised to 4 plus 2 times x square y square plus y raised to 4 minus y raised to 4 minus 2x square y square plus x raised to 4 divided by 2 square is 4 and a square is a square, that is a raised to 4 is equal to 1. So So simplify this x raised to 4 plus 2x square y square. Y raised to 4 minus y raised to 4 minus minus plus 2x square y square and minus x raised to 4. The 4 a raised to here, it becomes 4 a raised to 4. Now see here, x raised to 4 minus x raised to 4 plus y raised to 4 minus y raised to 4. 2x square y square, that is 4x square y square is equal to 4 a raised to 4. Again, the 4 will get cancelled from both sides. Then, x square y square is equal to a raised to 4. Now, differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Then, using product rule, find the derivative of this x square into, take derivative of y square plus y square into derivative of x square, and derivative of this a raised to 4 is 0 since it is constant. X square, derivative of y square is 2y, derivative of y dy upon dx plus again y square as it is 2x 0. Now again this 2 will get cancelled from this side and x square into dy upon dx plus y square is equal to 0. Then it is x square into dy upon dx is equal to minus y square. Therefore, dy upon dx is equal to minus y square upon x square. Here, what do I have to do? That is dy upon dx is equal to minus y upon x. So, here our answer is 4x square into y square, that is x square as it is, y square. See, check this answer. Now, next question is what? That is, if x is equal to e raised to sin 3t and y is equal to e raised to cos 3t, then show that dy upon dx is equal to minus y log x divided by x log y. So again x and y both are the parametric function with parameter t. So differentiate with respect to t. So first of all, this is a function raised to function. So here we are taking log on both sides. Then it is log x is equal to log of e raised to sin 3t and here log y is equal to log of e raised to cos 3t. So here log x is equal to log sin 3t into log e and log y is equal to cos 3t into log e. Therefore, log x is equal to sin 3t only because value of log e is 1 and here log y is equal to cos 3t since log e is equal to 1. Now differentiate with respect to t. Therefore, what is the derivative of log x? 1 upon x into dx upon dt. Derivative of dt, differentiate with respect to d. This is derivative of x log x, 1 upon x. Derivative of x dx upon dt is equal to derivative of sin 3t. That means derivative of sin 3t is cos 3t into derivative of 3t is 3. So dx upon dt is equal to 3x into cos 3t. 3x into cos 3t. Now see here, 1 upon y into dy upon dt is equal to minus sin 3t into derivative of 3t is 3. Then dy upon dt is equal to minus 3y into sin 3t. Therefore, by using parametric functions, d1 upon dx is equal to d1 upon dt divided by dx upon dt, then minus dy sin dt divided by 3x into cos 3t. So here 3 will get cancelled and y upon x into sin 3t upon cos 3t as it is. Now next, now see equation 1 and equation 2. Y is a minus sign and value of c here, log x is equal to, so here x is equal to e s to sin 3t. Log x is equal to value of sin 3t. Value of sin 3t is value of log x. Therefore, minus y upon x as it is, value of sin 3t is log x. And divided by cos 3t, that is value of cos 3t is log 1. So here we are going to prove dy upon dx is equal to minus y log x upon x into log y. Question number 2. Next, third example, x is equal to t plus 1 upon t minus 1 and y is equal to t minus 1 upon t plus 1. Then show that y square minus dy upon dx plus z. Now see, here we have given x and y. T plus 1 upon t minus 1 and y is equal to. Now this y can be written as 1 upon t plus 1 upon t minus 1. This value can be written as, suppose for x upon y, it can be written as 1 upon y divided by x. Similarly, I am writing this as 1 upon t plus 1 upon t minus 1. So from this I am taking minus 1 common, then this will be t plus 1 upon 1 minus t. T plus 1 divided by t minus 1 and take minus sign common from this, then it is t minus. But this is a value of, this is a value of, the question is wrong here. This is not t minus 1, this is 1 minus t here. This is a 1 minus t. 1 minus t. Then if we take minus sign common from this, then the 1 minus t can be written as t minus 1. Minus 1 as it is, and this is the value of x. A question incorrect about that. Jamaal dursi karun ya hai t minus 1 cha hai jiti pa hai 1 minus t. Par answer chukta dursi ka direct kera tha. Y simplify karun hai klapun. Y is equal to, then we will get minus 1 upon x. That is x y is equal to minus 1. Now differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. X into dy upon dx plus 1 is equal to 0. Then dy upon dx is equal to minus y upon x. This implies xy is equal to minus 1. If we differentiate this, x into dy upon dx plus y is equal to 0, that means here we are going to do y square. So d dy upon dx is equal to minus y upon x. But here we see y is equal to minus 1 upon x. Dy upon dx is equal to minus y upon x. So this y can be written as it is, and minus 1 upon x again it is y. So dy upon dx is equal to y square. Then dy upon dx minus y square is equal to 0. So here plus sign changed by minus sign. Y square minus dy upon dx can be changed by, here we will take this side, then it become y square minus dy upon dx. Both the times the answer is correct. Now see, next question, question number 4 here. X is equal to a cos cube t. And y is equal to a sin cube t. Then dy upon dx is equal to minus y upon x plus 2 upon 3. Now see here, again we have given two parametric function, a cos cube t and y is equal to a sin cube t. So differentiate with respect to t. Dx upon dt, a is constant, derivative of cos cube is 3 into cos square t into derivative of cos is minus sin t. So it is minus 3a sin t into cos square t, and dy upon dt is equal to a into 3 sin square t into cos t, that is 3a sin square t into cos t. These are parametric functions, so first and this is second. Therefore, by using parametric functions, dy upon dx is equal to dy upon dt divided by dx upon dt. What is the value of dy upon dt? 3a sin square t into cos t divided by minus 3a sin t into cos square t. 3a cancel will, sin square into sin and cos t square. So here we get minus sin t upon cos t. Equation first. This is the value of dy upon dx. Now see equation 1 and 2 given equation. That means x is equal to from 1 and 2 a cos cube t, and y is equal to a sin cube t. Therefore x upon a is equal to cos cube t, and y upon a is equal to sin cube t. If we take cube root on both sides, cube root on both sides, then it becomes x upon a raised to 1 by 3 is equal to cos t, and y upon a raised to 1 by 3 is equal to sin t. Now, using this value of cos t and sin t in equation 1, therefore equation first becomes dy upon dx is equal to minus sin as it is. Value of sin t, 1 upon a raised to 1 by 3 divided by value of cos t, x upon a raised to 1 upon 3. Here denominator a raised to 1 by 3 will be cancelled, and power of y and x is 1 by 3. So minus y upon x raised to 1 by 3. Hence it is 2. Now question number 5. x is equal to then show that d1 upon dx is equal to minus under root 3y upon 2x. See solution. Again, this can be written as x by 2 is equal to cos raised to 4 t plus 3. And here, y upon 3 is equal to sine raised to 4 t plus 3. So, here we are taking square root on both sides. Square root on both sides. Then, if we take square root of this cos raised to 4, then it becomes cos square of t plus 3 is equal to under root x by 2. And sine square of t plus 3 is equal to under root. Why are we taking square on both sides? If we take square on both sides, then it becomes sine square and cos square. And here we use identity, that is sine square t plus cos square t is equal to 1. We know that cos square theta plus sine square theta is equal to 1. But here value our angle is t plus 3. Then cos square of t plus 3 plus sine square of t plus 3 is 1. What is value of cos square? That is root x by 2 plus root 1 upon 3 is equal to 1. Now differentiate with respect to x. This can also be written as 1 upon root 2 into root x plus 1 upon root 3 into root 1 is equal to 1. So see here, by taking derivative, 1 upon root 2 is constant, so write as it is. Now, derivative of root x, 1 upon 2 root x plus 1 upon root 3 is constant, write as it is. Derivative of root 1 upon 2 root 1, and derivative of 1 dy upon dx is equal to 0. Now, the 2 get cancelled here, because if we take common from this and this side, it is 0. So, the 2 becomes 0. Then 1 upon root 2 plus 1 upon root 3 into dy upon dx is equal to 0. Therefore, 1 upon root 3 into dy upon dx is equal to minus 1 upon root 2 and dy upon, sorry here, root x also. Root x and here it is root y. Root 3 into root 1 and root x. Therefore, d1 upon dx is equal to minus 1 upon root 2 into root x. And here it is root 3 into root 1. So, this can be written as root 3 y upon x in single root. Hence it is proved. Now next example number 6 here. X is equal to log of 1 plus t square and y is equal to t minus tan inverse, then show that dy upon dx is equal to under root e raised to x minus 1 upon 2. Now see, again these two function log 1 plus t square and y is equal to t minus tan inverse t. Differentiate with respect to t. Then dx upon dt is equal to log of t square, that is 1 plus t square into derivative of t square is 2t. dy upon dt, derivative of dy minus 1 upon 1 plus t square. If we simplify this, 1 plus t square minus 1 upon 1 plus t square, 1 will cancel, that is t square upon 1 plus t square. Therefore, by using parametric functions, dy upon dx is equal to dy upon dt divided by dx upon dt. Right value, t square upon 1 plus t square divided by 2t upon 1 plus t square. So denominator is same, since it will cancel, t square upon 2t, so t will be cancelled here. So dy upon dx becomes t upon 2, but here we have to prove that it is under root e raised to x minus 1 upon 2. Now see our equation number 1. Here value of x, so from 1 given x is equal to log of 1 plus e square. If we taking in the power of e, that is e raised to x is equal to e raised to log of 1 plus t square, and all of you know that e raised to exponential and logarithmic functions are inverses of each other. Therefore, e raised to x is equal to e and log will cancel, that is 1 plus t square. Therefore, t square is equal to e raised to x minus 1, and t is equal to under root e raised to x minus 1. Using this value here, therefore dy upon dx is equal to under root e raised to x minus 1 upon 2. Hence it is proved here. Now next question number 7, which is again a very easy example. You try this, x is equal to sine inverse e raised to, use inverse trigonometric function, sine inverse t derivative, that is 1 upon under root 1 minus t square, and find this. In example number 8, you should have to use substitution, that is 2bt. Instead of t, use the tan theta. Then it becomes, this b is constant, so put outside. Then it is 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. And this is a formula of sine 2 theta. Then x is equal to, write this and solve this example. Now see, our question number 4, this is very important examples. In exam, it will be asked. Example number 4, the last question, question number 7 and 8, you should try to solve. Question 4, differentiate x sin x with respect to tan x. X sin x with respect to tan x. Very important examples. To differentiate the x sin x with respect to tan x. So let us consider here that u is equal to x sin x and v is equal to tan x. That means here we have to differentiate the u with respect to v to find du upon dv. But see here, we are again using here parametric function. This u is a function of x and v is a function of x. But here we have to differentiate this u with respect to v. So first here we are going to find du upon dx and dv upon dx. So differentiate with respect to x. Then it is du upon dx. So using product rule, x into derivative of sine cos x plus sine as it is. Now dv upon dx is equal to what is the derivative of tan x? Sec square x. So by parametric functions, du upon dv is equal to du upon dx divided by dv upon dx. So this du, x into cos x plus sin x divided by sec square x, that is du upon dv. Using this side, you should simplify all of. Now see our next example. that is differentiate sine inverse of 2x. Again here we are going to use substitution. Second example, differentiate sine inverse of 2x upon 1 plus x square with respect to cos inverse of 1 minus x square divided by 1 plus x square. Again here we are going to use substitution. So let us consider u is equal to 2x upon 1 plus x square and p is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. So again here we have to find du upon dv. So let us take substitution. Put x is equal to tan theta. Then see here, u is equal to sin inverse of 2 tan theta upon 1 plus tan square theta and p is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus tan square theta upon 1 plus tan square theta. U is equal to sin inverse of, this is formula of sin 2 theta, and v is equal to cos inverse of cos 2 theta. In last lecture we already see this formula. Therefore u is equal to 2 theta and v is equal to also 2 theta. So here value of u and v are same. Therefore here we write u is equal to v. Then differentiate with respect to x with respect to v. Then derivative of u is with respect to, that is du upon dv, and with respect to u it is 1. Since the answer is 1. Now the next example, you should try to solve the example. In next lecture we start see our last point, that is higher order derivative. The remaining part of examples you should try to solve this.